And you know that, and it makes really no sense when you think about it, man. Because you look at like, okay, I already talked about how, you know, it was a conflation. It was like a conspiracy, collusion. You know, it was like multiple aspects of society or whatever, or even other cultures just like came together, you know what I'm saying, to facilitate this mammon scam, you know, to get a piece of the pie, you know what I'm saying, at God's expense, at my expense, well aware of what they were doing, you know what I'm saying, with knowledge of many. And so it's like, it's crazy because when you look at it, they say, you know, like people that, like these other cultures and stuff that benefited from it, they're saying, okay, these slanderous, like envious witches and warlocks or whatever, you know, that spread these defamation of things that I had no knowledge about, or, you know, I didn't know about. But it's like, you know, it's like it being like forced heavily on me instead of justice being rendered for it. Instead of justice being rendered for it, you know what I'm saying? It's like the crime or whatever they did, the defamation and the crime that they did is like forced on me instead of justice rendered for it. So it's crazy. Like, and you got these people that say things like, you know, these people did whatever they had to do. Like they say, they say this about the liars, you know what I'm saying, in regards to my situation. They'll say things like, the liars did what they had to do, or the slanderers just did whatever they had to do. And they, you know, they say that because they benefited from the crime as well, you know, from the false success. It's not a real success they have. It's all staged. And so they benefited from that too, at my expense, you know what I'm saying, at my death, you know, at my murder, at my destruction, utter, you know what I'm saying, utter diminishment and things, and for, yeah, and knowing that I only stood for the purposes of God in the first place. And so, you know, they say they did what they had to do. I mean, by that's a two-way street, you know what I'm saying? It's like, well, they did what they had to do then to preserve and protect my babies, you know what I'm saying, which is my art. Then I do what I have to do. And really, I don't have to do much but just tell the truth. And that's all I've been doing, embracing the truth and just being reality, embracing reality of what I know myself to be, who I know myself to be, what I know the substance, you know, the content of my character to be, what the content of my contribution is, you know what I'm saying? Just knowing the truth or reality of the situation. I ain't doing nothing, you know what I'm saying? Really, but just existing. All I'm doing is existing just because of the gravity and the magnitude of the lies and the campaign that they concocted and orchestrated and created on falsehoods. You know what I'm saying? That's their bag. They did what they had to do. And then, you know, I don't have to do nothing but exist, because what's fake don't last. You feel me? What's real lasts. That's just true. They built their castle on the sand. You feel me? Mine was on the rock, the foundation which was in the Lord. So that was a personal issue, you feel me? That was something personal that they, you know what I'm saying? That has no bearings on my reality. But yet again, you know, I see another tactic, and demonic tactic, whereas you got these influences. I've already talked to people about this psychological warfare tactics and strategies that I talked to them about years ago already. It's one called suggestion. And it's where they, for one, they already sensitize you to, you know, or a set board of, you know, like, information, you know what I'm saying? And for me, it was this acronym jump. And then from there, they get everybody like normalized to it, sensitized to it. They sensitize you to that. And then, you know, so they know you're gonna pay attention to it. And then that's when they can insert in, you know, they insert in like other people's names and stuff. People that ain't got nothing to do with the equation, they insert them in, they draft them in psychologically. You feel me? And when people that's I guess haven't always been sensitized to the campaign, they just hop in and then they start to catch on. Then they see that and then they take it as whatever they perceive or believe that you perceive or believe, then they believe that you accept that. You know what I'm saying? Because that's why they insert those things into certain equations at certain times to like suggest that thought or that concept or that idea, you know what I'm saying, into the world, into society, into everybody. So people associate things that don't associate together psychologically. You know what I'm saying? And they're doing this to lay the seeds for like, it's like pretty much to plant the foundation for, you know, destruction. Or I don't know what it is, you know. I know they're attacking my legacy and things because they're trying to cover up the evil that they did, which is not my problem. You know what I'm saying? Because I mean, they tried to hinge, you know. And the thing is, what bothers me the much, you know, that much is that, you know, like all this time they tried to hinge like other people's lives, other people's successes, other people's you know, like downfalls, or you know, for anybody that when anybody evil or darkness get exposed, or people start to see it unravel, or these influential figures, how evil they are, you know, becomes widespread, known, and manifest, then they were going to use that to like bring me down with them, which, and I'm totally unrelated to them, their reality, or anything of their culture. And that's the situation. My problem is with it is, if I hadn't had a testimony throughout the course of the years, catching this situation every single day, you know what I'm saying, in real time, and making it go viral everywhere, you know what I'm saying, national and global, the whole time it was happening, then it would be like, okay, they got me. You know what I'm saying? This Antichrist, Satan won or something. But that was not the case. I was on the scene the whole time. You feel me? Telling everybody everything. And I even told them that this is what I told society. I'm like, this is what they're trying to do, you know, to an unsuccessful person for following God. You know, I told everybody. So that's why I'm not standing. I couldn't stand for it, because they had, you know, I informed everybody who, you know, to whom it concerned. And that's been the situation for the longest. And I'm like, okay. And then they say that, okay, this is true. This have happened before, but it's not going to happen again. I'm like, okay, well, here's your chance to prove it. You know what I'm saying? You see, they trying to draft me to other people's realities in order to destroy me with. I'm totally unrelated. And that's in the interest of influential figures and also guilty entities and people like that. You know, that's not my problem. The evil they did and got and absolutely get that backfired on them, that don't mean destruction for my legacy. That should mean time or something for them. Like, what is going on? Like, that's weird, you know? And so, you know, time and time again, you know, we see these reality manifest, you know, it's like cycles. The Bible repeat, man. But you see these the time in which we live, you know. But this is an example, you know. So say they did whatever evil they had to do. Man, nobody have to do evil, you feel me? Especially against God, knowing that it's against God. You know. So I mean, just like that, though, I'm doing what I gotta do. And that's follow God. Be truth. Be truthful, you know, speak the truth, embrace righteousness, embrace the Holy Scripture, you know what I'm saying, and the right thing, which I have been doing the whole time, as people can see, you know. And so, I compromise nothing. I fear no evil. God's still with me. I still got my faith still strong, you know what I'm saying. I'm going to stand firm in that faith, you know what I'm saying, until the end.